In the last video, we worked a very specific example of a linear ordinary differential equation. Now we're going to solve a general linear ordinary differential equation. That is, an equation of the form derivative of y plus some function of x times y equals some other function of x. And we're going to do this in total generality. Okay. We're going to use integrating factors, and here's the formula for the integrating factor. To get the integrating factor, you find the integral of p of x dx, and you exponentiate it. Now, there's always a constant of integration when you take the integral of p of x dx. Pick whatever constant of integration you want. Just let I of x be e to any antiderivative of p of x. Okay. And here's the key thing. If you take the derivative of I, well, the derivative of e to the something is e to the something times the derivative of what's upstairs. And the derivative of the integral of p is just p. So the derivative of I of x is p of x times I of x. And that means that if you take the derivative of I of x times y, by the product rule, that's I of x times y prime plus I prime of x times y. That's I of x times y prime plus I of x times p of x. We just said derivative of I of x was I of x times p of x, all times y. And so that's I of x times the left-hand side of our differential equation. So this gives us our technique for solving the differential equation. We start off with our differential equation. We multiply both sides by I. Great. We notice the left-hand side is the derivative of I times y. And then all we have to do is integrate both sides. Okay, you integrate both sides. And finally, you divide by I. Now, there's always a constant lurking in here. This isn't just one function. This is something plus c. And so you always wind up with an answer that's something plus c over I of x. So let's work an example to see how that works. So suppose we want dy dx plus 2xy equals 4x. In this case, p of x is 2x. This is p. And q of x is 4x. And when we integrate p of x, we get x squared plus a constant, but we can pick our constant to be anything we want, and it's convenient to just let it be 0. So our integrating factor is going to be e to the x squared. So e to the x squared times y prime plus 2xy is 4x e to the x squared. The left-hand side is the derivative of e to the x squared y. So e to the x squared y is the integral of the right-hand side, which is 2 e to the x squared plus a constant. Just do a u substitution here where u is x squared. And that means that y is 2 plus an arbitrary constant times e to the minus x squared. And if somebody gave us initial values, we could plug them in to find c. Okay. Last comment is that something very special happens if the right-hand side is 0. These are called homogeneous linear equations. And there are actually two different ways to solve the equation y prime plus p of xy equals 0. One way we just found, use integrating factors. You know, our formula says y is 1 over the integrating factor times the integral of I of x q of x dx. But q of x is 0. And what's the integral of 0 dx? A constant. So our answer is a constant over I of x, or a constant e to the minus integral of p of x dx. But we actually know a different way to solve this equation. It's separable. You can write it as dy dx is minus p of x times y. So dy over y is minus p of x dx. Natural log of y is minus the integral of p of x dx, and there you have your constant built into that integral. And so y is, you take exponentiate both sides, you take get rid of the absolute value by putting in a plus or minus, and you get y is some complicated constant e to the minus integral of p of x dx. In other words, a constant e to the minus integral p of x dx. It's the same answer. And this is the solution to a homogeneous equation. And when you have an inhomogeneous equation, like this one, where you had a 4x on the right-hand side, you notice this part is the solution to the homogeneous equation. This part is a particular solution to this equation. When you learn more about differential equations in general, in particular higher-order differential equations, you'll learn how to solve linear equations as a homogeneous piece and a general piece. This is a particular example.